size of explosive. So it doesn't mean there'd be a giant bomb that would blow the whole airplane to smithereens with lots of heat signature. It could be done with very little bit of explosive.
So this is about an explosion at all. Meanwhile, I know you've been quite skeptical of this whole report that the plane swerved and then circled around before it went down. You're skeptical of this, but if it were true, would that possibly indicate there could have been some kind of struggle in the cockpit?
Highly unlikely. I think what we're looking at right now is an airplane that came apart at altitude, and perhaps what the radar was seeing was the pieces of the jet as it spiraled down before it hit the water.
Okay, Steve Gainey, thanks very much.
All right there, George. The Charles de Gaulle Airport in Paris is, you know, major focus of the investigation as authorities try to determine whether a security failure allowed a bomb to get on board. ABC's Alex Marquardt is in Paris. Has more on that. Good morning, Alex.
Good morning, Robin. This is one of the biggest and busiest airports in the world. The security measures that are in place at Charles de Gaulle are some of the strictest. But as this mystery deepens, there are more and more questions about a possible major security lapse. This morning, the security measures at Europe's second biggest airport under intense scrutiny. After MS-804 fell out of the sky with no warning, investigators here at Charles de Gaulle Airport are scanning surveillance footage for possible clues, wondering if someone, something, was able to slip through onto its grounds, spread over nearly 13 square miles. With more than 65 million passengers and almost 500,000 aircraft passengers every year, could an explosive device have been hidden inside the jet by an insider? Could there have been a failure in luggage inspection or screening airport employees? Charles de Gaulle uses standardized, strict European regulations for its security procedures like scanning passengers and recruiting staff. Around 100,000 people work here. When they show up for work, they go through the same screening as passengers. Since last year's Paris attack, more than 70 of the so-called red badges granting access to secure areas at this airport have either been revoked or not renewed because of fear of radicalization. There are no systematic sweeps of planes when they arrive here, and MS-804 only spent 90 minutes on the tarmac in Paris after arriving from Tunisia. Now both Egypt Air and the airport this morning tell us that there was no special sweep on this flight. But the cleaning crews here, which go through every plane, every hold, are specially trained to be looking out for weapons and explosives.
Robert. Okay, Alex, thank you. We're going to turn out ABC News Chief Investigative Correspondent Brian Ross with the latest on what officials are saying.
Well, good morning, Robert. Adding to the mystery this morning is the so far lack of claim of responsibility from either ISIS or Al-Qaeda, two terror groups that have never been shy about taking credit for deadly attacks. So far, nothing on their usual internet outlets.
Not just the airport in Paris. How about the other stops they made before getting there?
Well, that's a really important question. The aviation security officials are asking this morning why, if Paris somehow did smuggle a bomb past security at Charles de Gaulle Airport, it was placed on a half-empty red-eye flight to Cairo instead of one of the many other flights leaving later for major European capitals or the U.S. So that puts a focus on Egypt Air and that particular aircraft, which prior to arriving in Paris from those stops in Tunisia and Eritrea in northern Africa, two countries with notorious black airport security, and now a very sharp focus on who had access to that plane, not only in Paris, but in North Africa.
And as you heard of Alex's first stop, they didn't know security.
Surprising, very surprising this one.
All right, thank you, Brian. Thank you for your security concerns here at home right now, as well as passengers already face those extremely long lines from the